Hi guys, my name is Anuj Jindal. Welcome to my channel. Today we are going to start with another session of ESI MCQs, which are going to be very important for the upcoming RBI and SEBI examination. I've already started with the day-wise series, wherein I first started with controlling out of from management, and through three lectures on controlling, we discussed the entire controlling, which holds a lot of importance for the RBI and SEBI examination. Of course, you would know that. Now I'm shifting gears and moving towards government schemes, which are another important aspect pertaining to the upcoming examinations. We will keep moving back and forth. I will be covering government schemes for the next 3 to 4 sessions. Then I'll move back and talk about some aspects of management and probably finance as well. We will create a very good and very healthy mixture of MCQs as well as direct sessions, wherein I'm going to be talking about one or more topics. But the objective is to daily give you something so that you can understand things better and try and prepare things better for the examinations that are coming up. So today we are going to start with certain government schemes, questions on certain government schemes, and I'm going to follow it for the next 4 to 5 sessions, and then we'll move forward and talk about probably some aspects of management. So let us start with the session. So these MCQs based on government schemes that I'm going to discuss today are going to be helpful specifically for the upcoming RBI examination and also for the upcoming SEBI examination. I will be taking a total of 5 MCQs with detailed explanations, and this is pertaining to or specifically meant for or taken from government schemes only. Okay, so let's start with the first question. The question says, under Pradhan Mantri Shram Yogi Mandhan Yojana or Shram Yogi Mandhan Scheme, workers of which sector are included? It's a very easy question to start with. First of all, you need to remember that Pradhan Mantri Shram Yogi Mandhan Scheme or Yojana, the acronym is PMSYM, because RBI and SEBI are notoriously famous for giving out such acronyms. Is a pension scheme launched on 15th Feb 2019. So this is another information that I have for you here, which you need to remember. It can be asked directly, on which date was PMSYM launched? The options are unorganized sector workers, organized sector workers, both organized and unorganized, all government sector workers, and all workers earning less than rupees 15,000 per month. Now the answer to this question, if you know it, put it in the comment section below. Let me provide you with the answer. The answer is A, unorganized sector workers. A little bit more about Pradhan Mantri Shram Yogi Mandhan. As I said, it was launched on 15 February. It is only for the unorganized sector workers. What exactly is an unorganized sector worker? Where in the employment terms are not fixed and regular. That is, you don't know when are you going to be fired. Wherein the enterprise probably is not registered with the government, or you're not getting social security benefits. For example, street vendors, cobblers, rickshaw pullers, all these people do not have any social security benefits. This particular scheme is going to come under the Ministry of Labour and Employment. Very important aspect. Regularly asked by RBI is another question, that is, from which ministry or in which ministry is this particular scheme implemented by. Under the scheme, a fixed monthly pension of 3,000 will be paid from age 60 to the persons earning not more than 15,000 per month. Unorganized plus your monthly income should be below 15,000. These are the two important parameters. How much pension? 3,000 rupees. Age after you turn 60. And what is the age limit within which you can apply in the scheme? 18 to 40 years old. As per NSSO 2019, in India, 43.7 crore out of 46.5 crore workers are in unorganized sector. So this type of scheme is essential for a country like India. So here another important fact that you need to remember is 43.7 crore workers out of total of 46.5 crore workers are in the unorganized sector, which makes almost 93%. Now some recent facts say that it has gone down to 86%, but this is the government fact given by National Sample Survey Organization. No recent government fact talks about the division of organized versus unorganized, therefore it becomes important. Let's come to the second question. I hope you have learned a lot from the first question. A person, if enrolled in any of the below schemes, cannot avail the benefit of Pradhan Mantri Shram Yogi Mandhan scheme. A person, if enrolled in any of the below schemes, cannot avail the benefit. Which of the following scheme has no impact on a person's inclusion or exclusion from PMSYM? So we have to find out the scheme which does not impact a person's inclusion or exclusion from PMSYM, or we can find out the schemes which have an impact on a person's inclusion into PMSYM. National pension. So PMSYM, even if you don't know much about this, you can actually answer this question. PMSYM is specifically for providing pension to people of unorganized sector. National pension scheme, employee state insurance corporation scheme, employees provident fund scheme. All these three are benefits provided to people of organized sector. If you belong to the organized sector, only then can you claim these kinds of benefits, because they are nothing but social security benefits. And as I said, people from the unorganized sector are called unorganized because they do not get these social security benefits. Therefore, this directly violates the definition of organized versus unorganized. The fourth one, Atal Pension Yojana, is also meant for people of unorganized, employees of unorganized sector. Naturally, our answer becomes Atal Pension Yojana. A little bit about NPS, ESIC and EPF. NPS is a government-sponsored pension scheme which was launched in 2004 and which was opened for everybody in the year 2009. Employee State Insurance Corporation scheme is a self-financing social security scheme, and recently a lot of changes have also been made in ESIC. Employee State Insurance raised the monthly wage limit to 21,000. So if you're an employee and if your monthly wage is below 21,000, then you can get enrolled in ESIC. 15,000 was the older limit. An employee's provident fund scheme is mandatory for salaried employee earning less than 15,000 per month. So this is the latest limit, but there have been certain changes. I believe I discussed those changes in a recent scheme as well. Atal Pension Yojana, I said unorganized sector workers only. Okay. Next question. Under the Pradhan Mantri Kisan Samman Nidhi, the funds are to be electronically transferred via state notional account through DBT. Funds are to be electronically transferred under Kisan Samman Nidhi via state notional account through DBT. On the other hand, in case of DASH states, the central government is required to transfer the funds directly to beneficiary's account, not involving state notional account. It's an important question here, an important point here which needs to be remembered, because there are some states out of these options that I have given who have not been able to provide Aadhaar card number to every citizen, and therefore they have been excluded from the method of providing benefits of Pradhan Mantri Kisan Samman Nidhi. In case of these states, the benefits are provided directly by the central government by transferring funds into their accounts, not using their Aadhaar numbers, because the Aadhaar coverage is not complete. The answer to this question is A, J&K, Assam and Meghalaya. Under Pradhan Mantri Kisan Samman Nidhi, a total sum of rupees 6,000 per year is provided in 3 installments. I am sure you must be aware about it. It's very popular scheme. In case of 3 states, as I said, These are transferred directly to the bank accounts without involving the state notional account. That's why I wanted to make a question on this. Next question is, to provide adequate content of high quality education under the Operation Digital Board. So here we are talking about Operation Digital Board. MHRD has launched many e-portals. Among the following, which is not related to Operation Digital Board? E-Paathshala, Diksha, Swayam and e-filling. Called as e-filing, but it's e-filling because it says double L. Okay. The answer to this question is D, e-filling, which is related with income tax, which is related with filing income tax online. All the other three, e-Paathshala, Diksha and Swayam, are online portals which contribute towards Operation Digital Board. It was launched in the year 2019 in February, and under this Operation Digital Board scheme, Digital or smart boards are going to be provided to all government schools. Let's come to the next question. Which ministry has launched quality assurance scheme for basic composite medical laboratories? Quality assurance scheme for basic composite medical laboratories, a very confusing question. Keep in mind, this particular question specifically can be asked in the exam. Ministry of Health and Family Welfare, Ministry of Ayush, Ministry of Chemicals and Fertilizers, Ministry of Commerce and Industry. I would like you guys to answer it before I answer it. Put your answers in the comment section below. Pause it for a while. Take the risk. Let us see who answers it correctly. The answer to this question is very unexpectedly D, Ministry of Commerce and Industry. What is the basic purpose of quality assurance scheme for basic composite medical laboratories? In short, the basic purpose is to ensure that whatever laboratories are there in the country, they are able to comply with certain quality standards. Now, these quality standards are determined by NABL, and NABL comes under QCI, Quality Council of India, which comes under Ministry of Commerce and Industry. Therefore, this particular scheme goes under NABL, which is under Ministry of Commerce and Industry. So this was the important thing that I wanted you to remember here. Okay, I hope you have understood this. This is the difference or the hierarchy. Ministry of Commerce and Industry, under which we have Quality Council of India, under which we have NABL, which is the board which looks after this particular scheme. I hope this lesson helped you understand more things related to government schemes, related to various government schemes. You know, there are n number of government schemes and n number of lessons that can be created. And therefore, I try and come out with the most important schemes first there, so that you're able to benefit from them and you're able to replicate some of these in the final examination. If you like this session, do not forget to subscribe to the channel, because I will be coming out with daily sessions of the same kind, and you will be able to get notifications only if you subscribe and press the bell icon. All the very best. Take care.